Well, we just watched season 7, episode 6 of MAFS UK, and we are loving it. We are loving the places that you guys get to go to.
Aw, that's cute.
My favourite couple still is Zoe and Jenna, and I love Zoe now. I really love Zoe. Why? Because her personality is very similar to mine. It's so similar to mine, so I'm loving it. I love her because I know why she's doing what she's doing. First of all, let's talk about the meat situation. I am laughing so much because...
I knew something because when they had the episode, previous episode, and she was freaking out about the eggs, I was like, okay, someone's going to keep going on about this.
Catching up eggs.
So yeah. When they started going on about the whole veganism again, I'm like, okay, here we go. It's going to be their big thing, I think.
Yeah, it is.
The whole season.
It really
They're
is.
They're going to have massive drama. I just can... Like, otherwise, they'd be a good couple.
Yeah.
I think they'd be a good couple if... But
I They're know, very yin-yang. And no, I love it.
That when it comes to people who are vegans... And I'm cool with vegan stuff. Like, I actually like...
I want to mention this. Marzi is a massive meat fanatic.
I am.
Massive.
But I don't
But she loves vegan food.
Vegan food.
She actually, loves it. She loves vegan meat.
I'm not... I can't convert because yeah. I still like the taste
chicken
of
wings.
Normal meat. But,
she loves chicken wings.
But I don't mind it.
Yeah.
I love grilled. The grilled burgers...
Oh, yeah, she loves grilled. She loves it. The like, vegan grilled burgers.
I don't know. Anyway, regardless of that,
yep.
When people are vegans... They're very, and it's cool. They're very strong, their convictions.
Yeah.
So I don't see
because even though she isn't
overcome that.
Even though Jenna isn't pushy, she is. She is. She goes, oh, what are you going to order? Like she's giving her, glances.
She's passive aggressive.
Yeah, passive aggressive. Exactly. That's exactly what she is. And it makes you feel like, oh, I have to do this. You know,
yeah,
she
I know
does that vibe.
Really like I could tell. She wanted the medium rare.
Yeah. She wanted the medium rare. That was so funny.
You could tell, she couldn't. She had to get the medium.
God forbid if I have it medium rare and it's still boring on the place.
And I laughed so much at what Zoe said. She is fun. I love her. And the reason why she's in her own head, I'm going to tell you why, because this is my personality. When I really like someone and I'm in my own head, I'm very future focused. And the reason why she's always questioning everything long term is because she really does care about her. I'm telling you now, she really does care about her.
Me and you, would we work on the outside?
So when you care about someone and you're future focused, you start getting in your own head and you start thinking, are we going to work long term? And this is what she's doing. So I understand what she's doing completely. You know, I prefer not to care about people now because then I'm not in my own head and then I come across carefree. So, yeah, that was really interesting. Okay, so now PJ and Jess, what do you think of these two, Mars?
Yeah, so PJ has asked Jess again what her thoughts are now that it's sort of settled down of him being a stripper. And she's come out and said it's not really about the stripping. Or it's more so about the fact that he's going to be out partying on the weekend. She wants someone
I think she
with
said
her.
That she wants someone with her all the time.
Want to be with someone all the time. Do you know what I mean? A bit needy.
Yeah, well, she admitted that she was clingy.
Yep.
She also said that because she wants to have kids in the future, she wants someone there, like someone that's reliable, that can support her and that can be there.
How am I going to build this life with someone who I don't even bloody see?
I'm so surprised because I thought it was just the reason that he was a stripper. Like, you know...
So there's more to it than just the job itself.
I'm so surprised. I really, really am. Because I just thought, you know, she looked down upon the occupation, but she didn't. She just wants someone there 24-7 with her.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm curious what job that she actually wants. Because no one who works is with someone 24-7, you know?
Well,
so I found that fascinating.
I think she wants a kind of 9-to-5 job when they're home on the weekends. I think that's what she wants.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was very, very interesting. Whether or not it's true, I don't know, but that's what she's stating.
That's what she's kind of
That's what she's stating,
anyway,
exactly.
Yeah.
So what do you think of them two? Do you like them? Do you think they're going to work? I think he's so nice.
I feel like
he's really nice.
She's sort of put him in the friend zone.
Yeah, she's
And I don't think she's seeing him more than that. Like, he wanted to give her a massage.
Meow.
And she's just like, no, I'm not having it.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
yeah.
You don't want a guy to give you a massage? And
see,
she didn't want it.
Marzi knows I wouldn't date a stripper. I just would not date a stripper. At all, but his personality is so, so lovely. It's, yeah, he's a gentleman. He comes across like a gentleman.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Yeah,
so that surprised me
if
as well.
She doesn't want him, I'll take.
Yeah, I knew you'd say that. I knew that's your type. That's your type. He's lovely. He looks good at his top one. I must say that. Hear that, PJ? Then we have our most funniest couple of all, Kwame and Kasia. I love these two. I love them so much. Now, Marzi, she said something about a mango seed.
Oh,
I know
yeah,
she did because I love mangoes. So my ears pricked up.
She's ready to move on to the physicality of
Yeah, she's ready,
right?
You know.
He doesn't want it because obviously he's not attracted to her.
No.
He's just not.
He's trying to be a gentleman
on film.
Right? He's trying to be a gentleman
on film. He's saying, like, oh, it's not a speedboat. you know, you got to take your time. But she's
like that. If a guy ever says to you, it's not a speedboat, it's a yacht, you know he's not interested in you.
Yeah.
Because a guy can't wait to jump your girls. A guy cannot wait.
But she's obviously there. She wants to progress. She wants the relationship to, come on, we're in a marriage, let's get going.
And do you remember the speech she said?
Yeah, so they're in the sunbaking and she's saying that our relationship, you know, we're like a plant, we're like a mango. You know, you got to water us, you got to nurture us. If you don't water us, we're going to end up like a dry mango seed.
If you don't water it, it ain't going to grow. If you don't nurture it, you have a dry mango seed.
She wants him to water her.
Yeah, okay? She needs to be watered. She needs to be nurtured so she's not a dried mango seed. Yeah. You know, she wants to be a voluptuous, juicy, rare mango seed. You know what I mean?
Right,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, I loved her. I love her. She is so funny. But
I think he needs to kind of be more honest. And I know he's probably being careful because he doesn't want everybody to hate the fact that he's not attracted to her.
Yeah.
But I think he needs to be a bit more honest and just say, I'm not attracted to you.
Everyone's so worried now what they're saying. Like, you know, there's a right way to say things and what isn't. And I don't care. Yeah. I don't care. I'll just say that, look, I'm not attracted to you.
But if he keeps dancing around it, it'll come out anyway. Yeah. And he's going to end up looking even worse.
Exactly. And people hate that, you know. Yeah. He should just say, look, I'm not attracted to you. You're a bigger girl. You know, I love your personality. You're great. You look like Toni Braxton, but your body size is way too much for me. Why can't he say that?
I mean, he'll get slaughtered for it.
Yeah, he'll get slaughtered.
That's the truth. He will get slaughtered for it. Either way, he's going to end up being the bad guy. And I kind of feel sorry for him.
I feel sorry for him too.
They never should have matched him with her.
No, I feel sorry for him too. So just remember that, guys. Not give him a hard time.
She deserves to be with someone who is attracted to her. That's the bottom line.
100%. Now our next couple, the Bon Jovi couple. The Bon Jovi couple. Shut to the horn, you're to blame. Oh, my God. I'm surprised that he's so interested in her. I'm surprised because I thought he's been around the block a few times and, you know,
he
really likes her.
I thought he would get.
And what's this whole licking his lip thing he's doing, Mars?
I don't know, he's like,
what the hell? Like, that turns me off. That turns me right off because you just don't expect him to do that.
I think it's turning her off too.
Yeah, it is. Like, but she's like,
I can't do it. It's too much.
Yeah, but she isn't expressing that to him. She comes across like she's really into him. Mm. So he's really perplexed. He's really confused. He doesn't know what's going on. He doesn't know.
Oh, he's not confused yet. He just doesn't know.
Yeah, but that's
he's like a deer in headlights.
He is.
He doesn't know.
He has no idea what's coming.
He's going to be very shocked.
Because watch her.
Yeah.
Watch her, guys, because she's like, you know, she comes across like she really likes him. She's very agreeable. Yeah. That's not her personality at all.
Finding it a little, like, draining.
Also, she's feeling like she has to be the mother here. She's feeling very, he is depending on her too much.
Yeah,
and that's really putting too much pressure on her, and she's starting to really freak out about that.
And he wants someone to mother him and take care of him. To a certain extent, I'm happy to do that. But that takes a real toll on me as well.
You'd understand that, Mars. You'd understand that.
So would you.
Would I?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, you not with boyfriends, but in the family.
The family. Well, she could understand that. So the family.
She's had to be the mother a lot. And you know what? With both of us, it drags you down. And then what will happen is she'll end up blowing up.
Sounds like me again. Sounds like me again.
Exactly. There'll be an argument. Something will happen, and he'll be like, "What did I do?" He won't know what's.
He'll have no idea.
Massive shock.
And he'll go, "I thought you liked me. I thought you liked me. Where's this coming from?" He's got no idea.
Vibes. Like he's like Mr. Fairy Tale.
He is.
And she's like, whoa.
No. Do you know Bon Jovi had a song called If I Was Your Mother? Do you know that? Because I was a Bon Jovi fan back in my heyday, and Bon Jovi had a song called If I Was Your Mother. Look it up, because this is coming true. This is coming true. Who really is Bon Jovi? So, I think this is so funny. But she's giving him complete mixed signals,
Yeah,
I can't believe it.
She should speak. Like, she said, should I speak up? She should.
Yeah.
And that will come out, I reckon, on the couches where they have the counselling, whatever. She'll just blow up and just say it.
Oh, can you take care of me some more? I think I'm a little disappointed.
Like, whoa, I didn't know where this came from.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm loving the show, guys. I can't believe you guys have a dinner party. You guys have a dinner party. We're so excited. I think it's on tomorrow night or tonight in the UK.
Tomorrow for us.
For us, it's tomorrow. For you guys, it's tonight. So we're so excited about that. Can't wait. Loving the show, guys. I'm so glad I'm watching it. Loving it.
Absolutely.